Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I'm Dr. Dafda, and in this 38th video class of DIP, we will study image formats, containers, and compression standards in digital image processing. Starting with the name, image formats are standardized means of organizing and storing digital images. Image container is one that handles multiple types of image data. And image compression standards define rules or procedures for compressing and decompressing images. So now very first question that comes in the mind is, what is the need of this image compression? See, every day and everywhere, number of image compressions and decompressions are taking place. So some standard is necessary so that there is compatibility or uniformity between the image communication and storage products manufactured by different sources. Okay, so let us start. This figure shows some popular image compression standards, file formats, and containers. The internationally approved entries are shown with black text and all others are shown in gray text. The standards for still images or pictures and motion images or videos are different. Still image standards can be further categorized into binary image standards and continuous tone image standards. The binary image is also known as bi-level image since it has got only two levels, 0 for black and 1 for white. The continuous tone images are either grayscale images or color images. Different binary image standards are CCITT group 3, CCITT group 4, JPEG or JPEG 1, JPEG 2, TIFF, etc. CCITT stands for Consultative Committee of International Telephone and Telegraph. Group 3 is a lossless compression format. Group 4 is a simplified and streamlined version of group 3. JPEG 1 is the standard given by Joint Bi-level Image Processing Group for binary images and is a lossless compression standard. While JPEG 2 is a new standard designed for lossy and lossless compression. The important ones for us are the continuous tone standards, which are JPEG, JPEG LS, JPEG 2000, BMP file format, GIF file format, PNG file format, TIFF file format, etc. And we will also see some video standards in short. Starting with JPEG, JPEG stands for Joint Photographic Experts Group. The file name for this JPEG is .jpg or .jpeg. It is one of the most commonly used format for photographs, and it is specifically good for color photographs or for images with many blends or gradients. But it is not best with sharp images and might lead to little blurring. Why? Because mainly JPEG is a lossy compression for digital photographs. So JPEG exploits two limitations of our human visual perception. First is the sensitivity of our eye to brightness variation is different depending on the spatial frequency. And second, our eye is much less sensitive to changes in colors at high spatial frequencies. So this JPEG is very popular and it is accepted for most of the programs, and it is quite popular for internet. Whatever transmission of images takes place through the internet uses JPEG. It is also used for digital cameras. It is used in our smartphones, etc. And this is mainly due to the fact that the high quality images can be saved using less space using JPEG, and also it uses very less bandwidth. Next is JPEG LS, which is lossless JPEG. So it is a lossless or near lossless compression standard for continuous tone images. It was developed with the aim of providing a low complexity, lossless and near lossless image compression standard that could offer better compression efficiency than JPEG. It uses predictive lossless compression method, and it is specially suited for low complexity hardware implementations of very moderate complexity, while at the same time providing state-of-the-art lossless compression performance. So it is a near lossless compression standard, but not used as widely as JPEG. Next is JPEG 2000, which is advanced JPEG that was developed in the year 2000. In fact, in between the year 1997 to 2000. So it was created subsequent to the successful JPEG compression with superior compression ratios. So its fundamental principle was to incorporate new advances in picture compression research into international standard. And normally JPEG uses discrete cosine transform, but JPEG 2000 uses wavelet transform. Its design delivers lossless compression rather than JPEG's lossy compression, which will retain more image data during the conversion process. But as it is more complex file, very few software applications support it, and these are not as popular as JPEGs. Could not be used for surveillance applications, and it is also not used in web browsers. Next file format is bitmap image. A bitmap image uses 8 bit per pixel per color, and this satisfies the requirement of resolution of of many displays. The CRT displays, LED or liquid crystal displays, has the requirement of 8 bits per pixel per color. Each value is an 8 bit number ranging from 0, that is darkest, to 255, that is white or brightest. And these values are proportional to apparent light intensity and not actual intensity. The actual intensity is modified by gamma correction, and we have seen this gamma correction while understanding image transformations in the spatial domain. So this is done by raising it to the power of gamma is equal to 2.2. Next is GIF or graphics interchange format. The GIF image is a lossless compression. It uses a range of colors up to 256. The format is an array of 8-bit indices into this region. And the GIF file may contain several images for animation purposes. GIF uses LZW compression. Lempel-Ziw-Welch compression is a compression of a file into smaller file using a lookup table algorithm. Next is PNG format or portable network graphics format. It is a lossless image format. We know normally the PNG files are larger in size. Images are normally represented by 8 bits per pixel format, but number of bits can be more also. Pixel has 3 color components and an additional 4th component for an alpha channel to indicate transparency, and that is optional, right? Next standard is TIFF format, that is tag image file format. When more than 8 bit per pixels are required or more than 3 color components are necessary, BMP format cannot be used, and instead we use TIFF format. It is used for uncompressed images. TIFF is also used for bi-level or binary images. TIFF allows several lossless compression modes. The most common is delta coding followed by LZW. TIFF is a common format for exchanging raster graphics images between application programs. It is also used for scanner images. And this slide shows some important points regarding video file formats. Most popular video file formats are MPEG-4, that is MP4, and H.264. And finally, this table shows the application and bitrate of some important image and video compression formats. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. Thank you very much.